Yes, just I'm moving here. Before going too deeply about my personal, just I'm going to ask you small questions. Do you have any predictions about our sixth sense? Do you have any prediction about our sixth sense? Do you have any predictions? Because I'm, yes, not an issue, Muhammad, that. Actually, according to me, the sixth sense is nothing but our mobile phone camera. Because most of the time, we are connecting with the mobile phone, and the problem with this, we are using mobile phone only for entertainment aspects, not for the teaching and learning purpose much. But after the COVID, we are integrating mobile phone for our teaching and learning purpose too. So I will try my, because I connected with good net connection, I will check whether the audio is any issues. So that's why I'm focusing here. Our sixth sense is nothing but our mobile camera. And even we already know that we have the five senses of influence, and through this only we are getting the wisdom and knowledge. Similarly, nowadays in the current scenario, we are gaining lot of knowledge through that kind of particularly for the mobile devices. Anyone kindly, Manoj, kindly help me to copy the things which I'm already shared in the chat box and paste once again the applications for me, please. So, am I audible? My voice is clear, Malini? Can you give the
Yes,
response?
sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, thank you. So please kindly check your net connections, others, please. Yeah. So now, in the case of the Education 4.0, I hope you already know what is Education 4.0. The Education 4.0 is representing that we have to incorporate the advanced industrial revolutions, particularly for the augmented reality, artificial intelligence, robotics. This kind of technology we have to incorporate, or we have to use in our teaching and learning process. That is called Education 4.0. In the case of teachers, we may call as a teacher 4.0. So now you can understood that the integration of the advanced level of technology, particularly for the artificial intelligence, robotics, augmented reality, virtual reality, mixed reality, these are the things if you are incorporating to our education practice, then it may call as Education 4.0. That tool which from the sides of the teachers they're using, they're called as the teacher 4.0. And just I'm going to start my small brief about the augmented reality after I move to the full of demonstrations. Yeah, I'm going with slow, not an issue. There is a three topic: augmented reality, virtual reality, and mixed reality. But due to the time context, I may focus on only the augmented reality, because the augmented reality it's part and parcel of the other technology of virtual reality and mixed reality. And before going to deepen my presentation, just I'm going to start a small activity call of you. I request all go to your Google Meet. So I hope you're already in the Google Meet. What you have to do, just I'm going to activate one questions. For this, kindly see this screen. You can find out there is a activity button in the right corner. In the mobile phone also, you can find the same activity button. Just I'm going to activate one questions. After that, the questions might visible to area. The first question, because before going to explain the topic, I want to know what is your level of the augmented reality. That's why just I'm going to launch these questions too now. 1 minute. Yes. Now the questions launch. If you click the polls, please kindly see. If you go to the Google Meet, you can go to the there is a small activity button. Once you press the activity button, you are finding the polls options. In these polls, you can find this kind of questions. The questions just now I posted here. Which definition best fit for the augmented reality? That's a question for you. I given the three options. Kindly select the options which is more relevant. Okay, kindly read. So the options are technology that turns physical objects into digital objects, technology that overlays digital information on top of the real-world items, technology that completely immerses users in the new digital environment. So for me, the answer is second one, that I'm selecting. Click the vote. So then finally, you can see the people, those are voted. So now I came to know that the first option is given by 6 people, the second option is given by 18 people, and the third option is given by the 11 participants. Fine. But the answer in this case of the augmented reality, the best fit definition is the second one, because this is called overlays, or we can tell as a superimposed digital information into the real objects. That is called as an augmented reality. So if you have any doubts about the activity, so very simple. Once again, I can because I'm going to conduct small activity in between. What you have to do, once you open your Google Meet, you can go to the there's a small activity button. there is a small activity, even the mobile phone is available. Once you press here, you can find the polls. A lot of options are there, like breakout polls, Q&A, but you can press the polls only. So this is an activity related to the polls as well. Yes, thank you. Yes, now I come back to my mobile screen. Yes, presentation. And one more question I'm going to ask to you. You have to give the answer in the chat box itself, right? The question is that we can combine all the three terminology, augmented reality, mixed reality, and virtual reality. All three things we can combine into single umbrella terms. Do you have any prediction about the term? We can combine all the three terms in a single umbrella term. Do you have any idea? Do you have any idea what is the term? Is that? Kindly type the answer in the chat box. Please kindly. Mixed reality, exactly the Pooja, I mean, exactly what you said is correct, but they hear the MR is already the mixed reality. But I'm talking about all the three terms we can come in a single terminology. Augmented reality, AR, mixed reality, MR, virtual reality, VR. So do you have any prediction, the three combinations being treated as single terms? Digital reality, okay, so much is okay, fine. Any other answer? Okay, the answer is extended reality. XR, the term is called XR, that is called extending reality. So why is it called extended reality? Because what are things we are seeing is not exactly real, but we are going to impose some kind of digital information look like a real. Therefore, it's called extending reality. We are extending the reality things in the virtual based. Therefore, these three terms we may call as a extended reality, augmented reality, mixed reality, and virtual reality. Just I'm going to highlight in where this kind of augmented reality that people are using. Already in the business sectors, they're using the augmented reality. I'm not explaining in what manner they're using. From the image itself, you can understand how they're using. And see, in the case of Air Force training, previously, someone can demonstrate or someone can explain the particular instruments or device. But nowadays, with a mobile phone, if you're scanning itself, we can be able to read the entire the missing spots, and they can explore by themselves. Therefore, the training aspects, the augmented reality is may helping a lot, but as a tutorial service to the students. And the other mode for the patient visit. Previously, if you want to, whether the search is fit for us, we can wear and then check it. But nowadays, with the mobile phone scanning itself, we can understand that which costume is most most suitable for us, which color most suitable for us. Everything the missions may predict and give that answer for us. Therefore, we can easily to go for the costume design and all. And the next thing in the education, and particularly in the science field, medical field, they are using a lot, particularly in the higher education. I don't know about whether the school system they're incorporating in a 100% perfect manner. But for explaining any kind of abstract concept in a concrete manner, we can depend this kind of the augmented reality or virtual reality tools because it gives us some kind of meaningful learning to the learner side. And the next way, field, civil and constructions. So even the civil and constructions, previously the civil engineer, they may give the two-dimensional image, but nowadays they're given a two-dimensional image. Once you scan the two-dimensional image with your mobile phone with specific application, we can know the interior decoration. We can plan the interior decorations well in advance. So this is also possible with the use of the augmented reality, civil and constructions. And you know there is a game, Pokemon Go. That is the first applications they integrate this kind of advanced, like particularly the augmented reality layers they incorporated. That is why 2 years before, this application is number one. Nowadays, PUBG and Firefight, it's coming in the field. But previously, most of the youngsters, they're using the Pokemon Go applications because of the augmented reality layer. Now I'm back to move to the demonstration part. For explaining the demonstration part, I can extend my mobile phone also for sharing the screen. But just I'm going to highlight the definitions after that I move to the demonstration part. The augmented reality and virtual reality is like a little brother, but don't think that both is same. There is a small difference, even some kind of specific difference also there in the case of the augmented reality and virtual reality. We can see the augmented reality even for our normal life. But in the case of virtual reality, if you want to see the virtual reality, we need some specific gadgets. So I hope my mobile screen visible, even I can open the other camera too. Please kindly see, I'm showing one box. This is called VR box. 1 minute, just I'm going to stop the virtual background. Otherwise, I don't see that anymore. So I'm going to stop the back, virtual background. Yes, now it's fine. Please kindly see my screen now. So I'm showing one small device now. This device is called a virtual reality box. The advantage of this box, you may get the some kind of virtual experiences once you wear it. And without this box, you can't see the virtual reality experience. But in the case of augmented reality, you can see without this kind of external box, we can use your mobile screen itself, we can view this kind of augmented reality impact. And the definitions of the augmented reality with the images, if I can explain it here. The augmented reality having the two layers. Please kindly note there is two layers needed. One is the physical layer. Please kindly see there is the table. This is called physical layer. So this is called real layer. So the table ego, see, can generate here one kind of digital information. So see, this digital information is totally artificial. This is called digital information. This digital information is totally artificial. So here we are, see, it's going to merge the two layers, real layer, this is called real environment, along with the virtual environment. Therefore, it is called as an augmented reality. So augmented reality, it's called as a superimposed digital information, is above the real environment. So therefore, it's called as an augmented reality. But in the case of the virtual reality, 100% virtual. There is no, you could not find some kind of real experiences or real environment in this. And see, she's using small devices. She's using the device name is called HMD, that is called head mounted devices. So once she see the table with these devices, she can be able to see some kind of cloak. That is a cloak totally CR virtual. We cannot be touched, but we can do some kind of manipulation through a sensor dish. That is possible. Therefore, I think that we can understand the meaning of the augmented reality. The augmented reality is a technology, this we know. But here, there is a superimposed. There is a superimposed information. That superimposed information is nothing but the digital information. So this digital information, you could not touch directly in your eyes, in your hand and all. So this is totally a virtual one. It's totally a virtual one. And the digital information, it may be sound, it may be image, it may be text. It means that it may support all the multimedia. It's supporting all the multimedia layers. And where you can find out this digital information, the world what we see, that is called our real environment. So in this image, the hand may be a real environment. So the hand may be a real one, that's for real environment. In the above the hand, you are finding some kind of virtual or the digital informations, like a mobile phone with water and two dogs. No? So this kind of experiences, or this kind of technology integration, it's called as an augmented reality. Therefore, augmented reality, just I give you the formula, then you can understand the meaning of AR. The AR is equal to real environment. So we can use the real environment along with the digital environment. So if you're blending the two environment, digital environment along with virtual environment, then it may call as a virtual reality. Just I'm going to the demonstration of the tool. So I hope my mobile screen is visible to all of you. Kindly type in the chat box. My mobile phone screen is visible. Yes, so here I'm already shared some of the tools needs. Kindly install in your laptops and mobile devices. Now I'm going for the one by one small demonstrations, how the augmented reality may help you for your teaching and learning process. See, just I'm clicking the AR, VR, because I'm already making a lot of grouping. That is called folder base. I'm already categorized the tool names. There I'm using there is a folder name, augmented reality and virtual reality. Thank you all to respond. Thank you all to respond to the chat box. And click the AR VR. And I'm going to demonstrate one by one. The first one, I'm going to explain the spacecraft AR. Particularly, those who want to know this spacecraft, it's not easy because we could not see to the Mars and how the satellites are functioning. We cannot know it. Even we cannot know how the rocket is reaching there. But we can get some kind of virtual experience with this. I'm opening this space graph here. I request Manoj to type the name of the tools in the chat box. Space graph. Yeah, yeah. If possible, if you are installing, kindly explore from there. Just I'm open this space graph and click the start mission. So once you click the start missions, you are finding the there is a five folder they given. So it's like a five packs they provide. One is called Earth base, some of the satellites, the Mars base satellites, and planetary base satellites. Then launch. So how the rocket launching may happen, and the other explosions also they may highlight. For the first demonstration, just I'm going to highlight how the launching, the rocket launching may happen. You are going to get some kind of virtual experience with this. Please kindly see, I'm clicking the launch. And in the launch, there's a two options. There's a two satellite. One is called Delta 2 Heavy. Once I press it here, automatically my camera may open. Now see, in this demonstration, my table is my real environment. My table is in a real environment. Once I focus with the application through the camera, there is a small detection happen, like small box. It means that my mobile camera is detected properly. Just I'm going to press this area. Now you can see there is a space Delta 2 Heavy. I hope you are seeing this one. Are you able to see this, the spacecraft?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, thank you. Now, I'm going to highlight this step-by-step process. Please, in down here, finding the stage zero. So it is a starting stage. Now I'm going to the stage one. Now you can see, I'm pressing the stage one. In down, you are seeing small error mark. I'm pressing the stage one. Now see, the rocket launching started. The stage one, it's processing now. The stage one is processing now. Yes, now see, it started now. The launching started now. Just I move to the stage one, because stage one is over. I'm into the stage two, of the rocket launching. I'm into the stage two. Now see the stage two, what it happened? The stage two is over. Now I'm moved to the stage three. So for example, this kind of abstract one, particularly we could not tell our students to go to the rocket launching area. Instead of we can show how the launching happened. This is called, I'm going to teach the abstract things in a concrete manner to my students. I move the stage three. This has happened the stage three. See, this has happened the stage three. And the stage four, just I move to the stage four. Now it will be happen the stage four. In the stage five, you can see the stage five. So finally the safe light, it may goes to the proper place and it makes the destinations. So I hope you now you are seeing the all the stages one by one. Right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
thank you, sir. Similarly, I move to the other rocket. So just if you like to go back, you can go to the back button. It moves with it. Just I'm moving to the Atlas, this other one rocket. Just you can focus in the place and keep the hand in the above. Now you can see the other rocket. This is called Atlas V551. So I hope now you are seeing here this again the satellite, sorry, the rocket which I'm showing now. I'm going back now and I'm going to show the other things. So still now we are talking about the launch. Suppose you like to know the Earth-based planet, which are the satellite it may find working for the capturing the sand, other things in the Earth, looking for checking the Earth. If you click the Earth, you can find it. There's a five important images. Eight images. Just I'm going to scan this space. Then immediately you may get this. This is called SMAP. Yeah, you can see the SMAP satellite. So I hope you're seeing in my room. So if you like to go back, I can go to the next one. So this is called Sentinel Michael Frisbee, measuring the Earth oceans. So I'm clicking here and scan. You can keep the mobile phone inside. Don't check here. And then first here, you can see the other one. So you are seeing the other one. This is called Sentinel 6 Michael. Then I'm going back. Then this for the third one. So this is called Sentinel 6 Michael. So once you scan, there is a detection may happen. You have to press the center screen. Then we can find out this things, otherwise you cannot look at this. So similarly, I'm moving to the next one. So this is for ISS, International Space Stations. Just I press the center. Once you press the center, your camera might open. You can scan this place and then press it here. And you can see. So now you are seeing the ISS. Yeah. So now, similarly, I'm moving to the next one. So now we are talking about the Earth-based things. Now I move to the Mars. So in which are the Mars-based satellites are there? You know, if you like to know about this, just I can press the center. Once you press the center, the space search is going. A lot of satellites are there. This one for the Curiosity, I'm just to press here, and you can see like how the Curiosity is working. So now you understand what is augmented reality, because I'm melting the two layers. What is the layer? The first layer is my real environment, is my table. In the above the real environment, you are seeing this kind of digital information. But here, this digital information is it's like an image, like some kind of GIF images, right? And similarly, I'm moving to the next one. So Curiosity, Insights. So all the things other place due to the time constraints, I'm not explaining all. Kindly explore the things, the satellites, different satellites which is available in these times. Yes, now I move to the other two. Yes, I'm coming back. So this is good for the children's, particularly for the above the 9th standard level. Suppose you like to teach alphabet to your children's alphabet. So even I'm going to demonstrate all the tools which is free. So I'm not using any paid tools. I'm going to focusing the tools which are the tools is free in the mobile phone, that only I'm focusing. And particularly if you want to teach the alphabet in your children's, even for your students, you can use the Animal 4D. The tool name is called Animal 4D. If you see the there is a fourth row, again. So the fourth row, the mid application, that is called Animal 4D, that's a green color plus number. Once you press here, you can find out this immediately my camera may open. Salima, I will demonstrate later how I do these things, how I share this thing to mobile phone. And see, I'm already having this paper. I hope you are seeing my camera. This paper I'm already downloaded from the web sources. Okay, if you go, type Animal 4D images, you can find this kind of images. After these images, you can keep the images in front of you, just as you can scan it. Now you can see A for ant. I hope you are seeing the ant. Are you seeing the ant?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, now I'm going to speak B for one. So now we are going to see B for here. And it's not a static one, it may be moving here and there. And yeah. Yes, now I'm going to highlight C for cow. So normally we are using only the some kind of for teaching alphabet, but we are using some videos only. Instead of that, you can tell the students to use them by personally. Even the teachers may explain with the mobile phone applications. And the elephant. Now we are seeing the E for elephant. Just I'm going to very fastly. Now F frog, F for frog. So this is for the zebra. Sorry, graphics. Graphic. Now H for horse. Just I'm moving the one by one paper. Then Yuguna. And this is for the kangaroo. So that's why I told this is for superimposed information. Please, in this example, my paper is a real layer. My paper is my real layer. We need the paper, exactly. So generally in the augmented reality, there's two types that also I'm focusing later. The first type is called marker-based layer, other one is called markerless layer. So for the marker-based layer, we need a paper. This is a one type of the layer. For markerless layer, we need this kind of paper. Without paper, it won't be work. And previous example, no? The previous example, I show the rocket launcher. That is called markerless layer. There is no need for any kind of specific paper layer. You can generate at any places this kind of actual experiences. Now the lion, you are seeing the lion. So you are seeing this lion. Yeah, of course, Mohan Kartika, you have to download this paper. Just you can Google it. Animal 4D free images. You can find out this images in one site. You have to download it. Even I downloaded things only I'm using. And M for monkey. Now this is one more good thing. Even we can explain the tools because I'm scanning the two images, banana with monkey. Now you can see the monkey is eating the banana. So the monkey is eating the banana. So like this, we can talk about the food chain also. And see the next one. So there is here, I'm going to scan this one. There's a grass. I think it's not detecting properly. I move to the horse, how the horse is eating the grass. You are seeing this one. I move this one, the flower. So how they inspect the honey from this flower. Now you are seeing how the cow is going to eat the grass. So this is totally free. Kindly download this paper from the Anatomy Cell Animal 4D applications. You can go directly from the Google images and just type Animal 4D free images. You may get plenty of images. You can download it. Even you can download all the alphabet A to Z. Then after that, you can install this application on mobile phone. You can explain it. Please, I request to Manoj, kindly type a specific application in the chat box. This tool name is called Animal 4D. Otherwise, our team member kindly help me. The tool name which I'm focusing here, Animal 4D. Animal 4D. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Now I move to the other demonstrations of the augmented reality. This is meant for the in the case of the science teaching, it might be good. So this is called assembler video. Please kindly note the third demonstration I'm going to do, assembler video. So I'm press the assembler video. Once I press the assembler video, even this is like a Google Classroom. You can create a classrooms like in a Google, but I'm not talking about how to create the classrooms and all. Just I'm going to focus in how we can use this tool for our teaching purpose. That's only I'm focusing.
Someone or something that is completely different
person. Yes, sir. So here you can find out they create a new classroom. You can create a new classroom. You can share the this kind of things regulate to them. So Rafiara, it is available. Kindly check in the Google Play Store. Now I move to this tool and press the topic. Once you press the topic, you are finding the different headings. Like life science, physics, math, chemistry, geography, history, earth science, astronomy, biology, English, physical education, social science, computer science education, religious education. So all the facts are free. Please kindly note, all the facts are free. So I'm basically from mathematics. That's why I'm going to focus in the one math applications in this. Once you press the math, you can find out the plenty of augmented reality facts. So, and one more good thing, it may suffer in the different language also. Suppose you like to find only the English language, you can press the all in the top. You can find out the English or Indian, you can press the English. Once you press the English, you can find out the lot of English based apps, so the features. Just you can press the symmetric, because I like to teach the symmetric concept to my students. Once you press the play button, it takes few seconds to download this the entire features. So this kind of small doll, it comes here and there. And it takes few, I am already mentioned, for each packs when you're opening it, it takes few seconds to download the entire features. After this, automatically your camera may open. You have to scan the face which is print off. Now it's ready. Now see, there is a lot of things are there, lot of images related to the symmetry. But what you have to do, if you want to explore the augmented reality features, you can go to the top. If you go to the top, you will find, see, there is an into button. There you are finding the two options, three options. The first one is for 3D. You can see this kind of 3D images. It's not augmented reality. Suppose you like to see the augmented reality experience, the second one, there's a second one. Once you press the second one, automatically your mobile phone camera may be open. Then you can scan the face. So just you can scan the face and keep the hand in the center. Then you can see you are seeing the symmetry. So here there's a circle symmetry and the other images, they can share the symmetry, and you can find the some kind of text message also. Like symmetry is the concept that is generally found in mathematics, especially about the geometry. However, you can find the concept used in arts and business. So suppose I like to go to the next one, I can go to the second one. Now you can see. Oh. sorry. Yeah. So there is a symmetrical and asymmetrical. So it gives some kind of example about the symmetrical and asymmetrical. So if the object is asymmetry, we usually call it is symmetrical. And if you cut in the center, we are getting the 2 points. But in the asymmetrical, it's not possible. Similarly, I'm moving to the next one. This is for the line of symmetry. So here they've given some of the example of the triangle, then square, then butterfly. So everything I think about. And the next one, I'm moving to be the triangle based. The next Euclidean triangle, then circle. So this is for the symmetry in the nature. So like this, we can teach any mathematical concept because the mathematics is abstract concept mostly. But we have to teach the abstract concept in this manner, in a quantitative manner. This is also possible. Please kindly note, this is a particular app. It may support in all the subjects. All the subject, only the things you can explore, which are the features they already given. Because due to the time and issues, I'm not explaining all. Once again, I'm going to demonstrate where you can find out this one. Once you open the assembler EDU, you can go to the topic. You can find out all the subjects like life sciences, physics, maths, chemistry, geography, the which subject you blank to. For example, you like to explore the physics, you can go to the physics. And in the physics, you are getting the lot of things like a gravity. Suppose I like to know what's the gravity. But these are the some of the things should be a paid one. Please kindly note. Wherever you find in the play, it's a free. Wherever you find the upgrade to access, it's a paid one. So don't go with that one, costing the money. You can use only that free version things, okay? Suppose I like to talk about the energy of life. You can first this one are law of motion, so law of motion and all money. First I'm going to the simple machines. And it takes few seconds to be download the feature. Yeah, to wait. Because each functional, each features, it takes few seconds to download the entire features. After that, only it may work in your mobile phone screen. So I'm placing the objects. Yes, just I'm going to scan their place in front of me. Now you can see. So this is called simple machines assembler based things. And this is make easier. They have the fun, no making, no imports. Just I move to the next one. So even they're given this is 7 images, you can go one by one. This was the 2x7, so how the scissor is cut the things. The third one, wheel with axle. The next one, inclined plane. The next one is a wedge. The next one is a screw. Next one is a pulley. Yeah, so like this, we can teach any simple machines things with the use of this tool. So this is purely based on the education. Even if we can use for the up to the higher education too, from the primary level up to higher education. Kindly explore the other features which is given in this tool. Now I move to the other tool, which is related to the same. That is called civilization here. So particularly those who are very much interested to learn the history, that area, we want to know about the previous history of the civilization. So you can use the civilization here, and it is made by the BBC based only. So automatically to open with civilization, and it's created by the BBC company only. Yeah. So once it's ready, you can keep your mobile phone in a static mode. Please kindly see. So yeah, that's why I told our sixth sense is our mobile camera. Because the mobile camera may help in a lot for our teaching purpose, particularly for gaining a lot of input, insights about the advanced things. And just I'm going to press the mobile phone in the center. Flat area, move your device slowly. So now it's detecting. You can press the hands. You can press the hand. Then you may get some kind of glow. You can see there is a glow. And here you can find out the different things. You can find the different things like Corinthian helmet, Rosetta stones, then corinium, cockerel, copper bowl, octopus storage jar. So like this, lot of things are available. So just I'm going back. Yeah. And if you go the right side, there is this Earth civilization. Then this is for the human body. Suppose you want to know the human body of the different areas in the civilization time, the faith, what is their faith, what is their encounters. So there's given the different headings. Now I like to go with this. For example, I want to know the human body. about the mummy type. So if you click here, you can see the mummy. So you can see the mummy. Yeah, so you can see the mummy in my friend, in my table. You can see the mummy. Yes, so if you go back, if you like to go back, what you have to do, in the top you are finding small probe symbol. No? If you press this, automatically go back. So now, once again, I am explaining the mummy of Egyptian. Just I like to go to the next one. If you go to the next one, you are finding the kiss by the Rodi and the artifact. Suppose you want to show the Titus Flavius Demetrius, how it will be. So just what you have to do, you have to press the center. Then you can see, you can focus the camera and you can see this area. So, yeah, I hope you are seeing this. This artifact you are seeing here. So it's showing like this. So, but you are seeing very small. I think you are not able to see properly, but from here I can see it from here. And similarly, if you go back, you can see the fourth artifact, the red figure neck. Then fifth one, the Peruvian style. And the sixth one, the Lady Ima. Suppose I like to see this one, you can first be this one and you can focus this area. So we have to human body, we have to project like this. You can see there is a image as like a wall. You can see that one. Yeah, just so this is purely based for the to explore this lot of civilization from Europe. You can go with this tool. So it's totally based on the historical tool and we explore it from there. And the next thing I'm going to focusing on, AR Lupa, because the AR Lupa, it consists of a lot of features. It's similar like this one. I already talked about the assembly video, you know, the same kind of tools, this one. Here they're given the different things, like if you like to go with the education, if you like to go with the entertainment, dinosaurs, or different things are there. And most of the features are free and some of the features you have to go for the payment, but I'm not going to go with the paid one. I'm going to demonstrate only the free options which is available here. Suppose I like to generate some animals in front of me. What I'm going to do, just press the animals. Once I press the animals, here they're given the lot of animals packs. Here you can check the animal images which is not having any amount that you have to use it, because some of the things you want to buy you have to give the 150 paisa, like this it is there, it's not amount exactly, so they give some kind of points, that points we have to get. Even when you create this application, they may give the 1000 points free, so the 1000 point you have to install some of the features too. Suppose I like to generate a camera in my room, just time press the camera. Then here my real environment, as I already mentioned, that my real environment, in this case my table, you can focus this table and press here. Now you can see, you are seeing the camel, and the camel is here, digital information. This digital information here is come as the video mode or GIF mode. Now I like to add the other animal too. I like to add the other animal too near to this animal. What I'm going to do, there's a plus symbol. You have to find the plus symbol. You can press the plus symbol. It's once again opening the same features. Here, what you have to do, you have to select the animal which you want to show to your students or show your children. Suppose I like to show the graphic, I can press the graphic. Then you can scan this place. You can press here. Now you can see, and you can minimize the also. Suppose it's very big, you can minimize with your hand. Now you can see there's a two animals near to me. Here. So, yes, it's fine. It's looking good. And you can minimize it, you can increase the size that it's possible from your end. And similarly, I'm moving to the one more plus. I'm going here, I'm going to make some kind of snake. Suppose the snake, it's in front of me, how we can feed. Just I'm press the snake. And you can create this space. So I'm creating the space for the snake here. Yes, now you can see the snake. So the snake and the three and two animals here. The snake is comes near to me. I hope you're seeing this. Yeah, similarly, I'm going to the plus. So like this, you can go with the n number of packs. N number of free layers which they provide, no, that you can use it and explain the things, particularly this kind of tools may create some kind of interest to the learner's sites. suppose I like to show the curve, just you can press the curve. I can create a curve also here to me. So tab here, place the objects. Yeah, now you can see the curve. You are seeing the curve. So there's a three, now the snakes are already falling down. Now that you are not seeing the snakes, you can see the other three things. So like this, which are things you want to explain, just you have to select and then explain these things to the students. And I'm coming back. I'm going to focusing on some of the specific education tools. So once I come back to the whole screen, the home screen of the ARLOPA, there you can press the education. Once you press the educations, you are finding the different packs like the microscopic collections, plants, human body parts, then cross sections work along, then candles. So a lot of things are there. Which things you like to explain to the students, that you have to select. Suppose I like to show the human body parts to my students. I can press the human body. And you can select the human body. For example, the first one, I want to show the human tooth anatomy. You can press the human tooth anatomy. Automatically, your camera may open. You can keep the hand where you want to generate this particular layer. So it's fine. It's detected, but I didn't press it previously. Yes, now you can see there is a teeth now. Suppose you like to create another one, you can go to the next one. Suppose you like to explain the blood vessels anatomy, you can press the blood vessels and you can focus the area which you want to generate. Yes, I select it here. Even you can zoom out. So now you can see how the blood vessels. And similarly, if you go to the plus symbol, you can see the other packs like human bone tissues, how the dental anatomy, then how the human heart functioning, then ventricles, spinal defect, brain. Suppose I like to show the brain, or I like to show the human anatomy body. I can press the anatomy body. I can scan the space and where you like to keep that times, because I already told you each times for opening any images takes few seconds to download the dental features. After you can press here. You can see the anatomy body. So in front of me, you're seeing some anatomy body. Yes, still the people. Sir, once you created the studio, once you created an account, automatically they're given the 1,000 points. So you can reduce the 1,000 points from this, and some of the layers are totally free. If you like to use that particular the yellow dotted one, from the three packs, you can use it. Okay, so if you more than 1,000, you can go for payment. More than 1,000 is better. If the institution's offering this service, if the institution buying this one, don't buy from an individual. You can insist your institution to buy this kind of code for the student's purpose, and then you can use it with their username password. That will be fine. So don't go for payment. It's an individual piece. Okay, because it's an education, so I'm sure it might help you for the entire institution only. Please kindly explore the other features like my model software package, COVID, and furniture. So a lot of things are available. Kindly explore from your end. Yes. So now I'll come back to the theoretical insights, because we are discussing a lot about the demonstration, but you must be familiar with the theoretical insight also. That's why I'm moving to the theoretical aspects. The augmented reality is a blending of, I already mentioned, there's two layers needed. One is for real environment. For example, my hand is a real environment. In the above the hand, if I'm generating some kind of artificial digital information, this digital information, it's like a superimposed, or it's like a blending. There's two layers of blending to each other. Therefore, it is called as the augmented reality. For exploring the augmented reality, these questions, you must be aware of it. What is the exact difference between the augmented reality, virtual reality, and mixed reality? See, this is a corner augmented reality. This is called virtual reality. The center part is called mixed reality. So there is a exact difference among this. In the augmented reality, we have the lot of real environment. We need a lot of real environment. For example, just for example, I put here. So we may get the 90% or 80% or 50 to 90% of the real environment is needed. And only the 10% of the virtual environment. So that is for digital information. Therefore, the digital layers may be less in the case of the augmented reality. right? In the case of virtual reality, you could not find any kind of real environment. The real environment, that's called R, it is a zero. It's a 0%. In the case of the digital information, it will be 100%. So what it means, in the case of augmented reality, we have the two layers, both real environment as well as virtual environment. But in the case of the digital world of the virtual reality, we may have the 100% virtual. And the mixed reality, like a 50+50, 50 real, 50 digital informations. Sometimes the percentage may vary also. Don't think that I'm giving the 50+50, it always the mixed reality. There's a chance based on the tool, based on the particular apps, can be changed. And generally the mixed reality having the small kind of interaction, even the participants or those who are using this tool, they have to do some kind of interactions or intervention in the digital information. That is possible. So that is possible in the case of mixed reality. And in the case of the augmented reality, if you want to see the experiences, if you want to perceive the virtual reality experiences, you must connect with this kind of devices. One is called head-mounted devices, eyeglasses, or contact lenses, or virtual retina, handheld devices, and spatial projector. But here I'm demonstrating everything with the use of the handheld devices. That is nothing but mobile phone. Because only the mobile phone only I'm able to share it. If I use the head-mounted device, eyeglasses, only I can get the experience. You cannot gain the experience. That is why I am demonstrating everything through the handheld devices, right? But this much of devices may help to understand or may help to explore the augmented reality features. But only things, once you use the head-mounted devices, eyeglasses, contact lens, virtual retina, only the people, those who are using it, they may get the experiences. Other people, they couldn't get it. And I'm just moving to the types of augmented reality with some examples also I'm focusing, with some specific applications also I'm going to focus on. The first one, augmented reality in levels. This, I'm not talking about the types, instead of the types, I'm talking about the levels. Because it is based on the levels only the type name comes. Please, I'm starting you. The first level, I'm not using the level one, here I'm using the level zero because it is the origination. It is the starting point of the augmented reality. The starting point of the augmented reality is based on the triggering. So some kind of QR code is needed. From the QR code only, you have to excel this kind of augmented reality experiences. Please kindly see my screen, my camera screen. So I'm showing some papers. What do you find from this paper? Can you type in the chat box? You can type the short form, that's enough. So what you find from my video, from my camera? So I'm showing one paper. Yeah, exactly, QR code, exactly QR code. So this is the starting stage. The hologram is in other technology. All right, so I'm showing some kind of code, that is QR code. In this code, I'm keeping in front of me. I'm doing the demonstration with the use of the tools called, 1 minute, just I'm going to share my mobile screen too. Yes, I hope my mobile screen is visible now. Kindly type Y if you are visible. So you can type Y is enough. Yes, thank you, Hasmi. Yes. Yes, thank you so much. Now I'm going to do the demonstration, 3D shapes here. Anyone can help me to type in the chat box? It is in the second row, third application. 3D shapes here. Once you press here, 3D shapes here. Then you can get this kind of screen. So in this screen, what I'm going to do, first we have to download this kind of paper. I'm going to demonstrate where you can download this paper. If you click the OK button, you can find out there is a download markers. Once you press the download markers, you are finding, it's asking to download one PDF file. That is the PDF file consists of these images. Then you can take a printout. After taking a printout, you can open the plate. It is meant for the mathematics teaching, particularly for teaching the three dimensions, very much complicated for the teachers. Because the two-dimensional board, it may help you to explain the two-dimensional images. But how we can teach the three-dimensional shapes in the two-dimensional board is very much difficult. But I'm going to highlight how we can use this tool for teaching the three-dimensional images and shapes. So you can see the octagonal prism. I hope you have seen the octagonal prisms. Thank you, Vijay Kumar sir, to share the link. It's called octagonal prism. And suppose I like to know the number of edges. Once you press the edges, you can see the edges. If you count the number of straight lines, the number of straight lines is equal to the number of edges. Suppose I like to know the number of vertices involved in this particular shapes. I can press the vertices. There is a dotted dotted. There is a lot of dots. Once you found the number of dots which is available in this shapes, you can find the number of vertices. Suppose if you like to see the know the number of faces, you can press the faces. You can see the entire thing maybe is rotated, and each side having the different color. Each side has a different color. If you count the colors, the number of colors equal to the number of faces. Therefore, the students might understood the exact the geometrical shapes very clearly. Then I move to the theorem, pentagon. Then hexagonal prism. We are seeing the hexagonal prism. Just I move to the hexagonal prism. Now we are seeing the cone, trapezoid. Now I move to the cube. Sorry, this is for the sphere. Now we are going to see the cube, cuboid. Okay. Then you are seeing the pentagonal prism. This is for the pentagonal prism. This is for the rectangular prism. So just I'm scanning this QR code. This is for the cylinder. So this is a triangular prism. This is a pyramid. This is a scale and triangle. So therefore, for teaching the three-dimensional image, now it's very simple. So this is a example for the. This is an example for the level zero. I hope now you understood. No, this is also another augmented reality. It's a starting stage of the augmented reality. It is working with QR code. So Selva Kumar, I already suggested the tool Alphabet. So I started my demonstration with Alphabet tool only. Kindly check that tool. Yes, that is called Animal 4D. You can go with Alphabet. Tasuria, so it's based on the tool. For example, we could not scan any QR code. So this application, no, it might working with the code which is available in this paper. And this code is created by the same companies, because this like a one can call. So this particular applications, it may working with this particular QR code only. You could not go with the scanning the any other code. It won't work. So because each company or each developer, they can develop their application only it's working with the papers. This kind of paper means you can take a printout at any paper. But there is a structure they made it, like they can keep some kind of small coding they may write it. That coding might work with the specific papers only or some specific layers only. Now I'm going to the second one, sorry, the first level. Yes, this paper is available in the app itself. That's why I told them there is a, you can download this paper from the net source. And the marker based AR, this is another type. So we need some kind of marker. There is no need for the QR code. But we need a marker. So for this, just I'm moving to the tool names called Anatomy 4D. And this the tool is good in the case of the for all the teachers, particularly for science teaching. I'm coming back to my and one more thing, this tool it's not available in the can we tell how? So how can we get from our mobile phone to system to I will demonstrate the finally please. Now the things that Anatomy 4D. This is an application is not available in the case of the Google what is that Play Store. You have to install through your browser only. You can type Anatomy 4D through the browser and download it. So after this, you can press the Anatomy 4D. This you have to find this kind of two papers once you install it. Please kindly see my screen. Are you able to see the screen in my camera screen? Please kindly see my camera. I can show some other paper. Thank you. So I can keep this paper in front of me. I'm scanning this paper that is called Human Body. And one more good thing, no? So automatically it may enable all the features. Just so you can disable the features. You can disable the features. After disabling the features, just you like to expand only the urinary system, you can press the urinary system. Suppose you like to highlight the skeleton system for the student, you can press the skeleton system. If you like to expand the reproductive system, you can press the reproductive system and remove the skeleton system. Which system you want to expand, that you have to specifically select. And suppose I like to explain the respiratory system, you can select the respiratory systems. Now I like to go with the circulatory, you can press the circulatory system. If you like to explain the gastro, you can press the gastro systems. Which the things you like to explain, that you have to take it. And these tools, I already mentioned that it is not available in the case of Google Play Store. You have to download from the browser, okay? And similarly, I move to the one more diagram. It's already given. Suppose you like to download this image, is where you can download in the sense. After installation is over, you can go to the three line. You can find the target library. In the target library, you are finding the two images. You have to download it. Otherwise, once you Google it, you can find this kind of thing. Adhirapash. These are things you have to download it well in advance. After this, come back to the Anatomy 4D and you can go for the scanning. You can go for the scanning. Then you can just scan. Now you can see there is heart. Even I can able to hear the sounds of the heartbeat. So I'm able to see. So this is called level 1. And similarly, there is another tool that is called Qver. There is also another tool, Q-U-I-V-R, Qver.com. That also you can explore from your end. Because we already time is up, I'm just moved to the third one. The third level, sorry, this is called third order, but this is a level 2. Because I'm short with the level 0, level 1, level 2. That is called Marcellus ear. This is working with the triggers. We don't need any kind of layers. We can generate this kind of activity at any place. Suppose I like to teach the how the planet, the each planet has rotating around the sun. So for this, just I'm opening my the packs. Yes. So here I'm opening the AR. The tool which I'm focusing is an AR solar system. I'm press the AR solar system. After this, you can find out this. There's a four options they provide, but the third and fourth options. So third options is meant for the virtual reality. Sorry, I'm sharing my screen, mobile screen. I hope my mobile screen is visible. Yes, thank you. Thank you to remind me, sir. And just I'm click the solar system. Now you are going to see the solar system in my room itself. Now you can see, because the solar system concept is very abstract. For teaching, it's very complicated to the teachers. But now the students can see how the solar systems, where this sun is located, where this earth is located, in what speed they are rotating. So everything they can see from my room itself. So in my room, it's a real object, real environment. In the real environment, you are seeing this information. This is called augmented reality. Even I can, there is a yes is for speed. We can speed up the process. If you, this is a represent zooming. You can zoom out, so everything you can expand. Now you can see the entire solar system. And if I like to see, there is a Uranus. Now the Neptune is near to me. So there is a Uranus. Now the Uranus is coming towards me. Saturn, Jupiter, Venus, Mercury, everything was seen from me. Similarly, I'm going back. This is called markerless here because I don't need any specific layer on this. I can generate this kind of digital information at any places. Wherever you like. Then you can go to the planetarium. So in the planetarium, I can just, here you can see lot of, even we can zoom reviews. There is this option called zoom in, zoom out that you can use it. Now this for the rotate, you can rotate this. Suppose I'm the layman in the case of the planet. Suppose I like to get the Mercury. I want to know more about the Mercury. Just you can open the Mercury and I can just read the Mercury informations. The Mercury is the smallest and innermost planet in the solar system. Its orbital period around the sun is 87.97 days, is the shortest in all the planets in the solar system. So AR solar system, please anyone can type in the chat box to help me the tool name which I'm focusing now. Yeah. No, it's not Qver. Please, it's not Qver. The previous one I have talked about, but this is AR solar system. Just I like to go with the next one, Venus. Thank you, Manjana. Then Earth. This is for the Mars. This is the asteroid belt. This is Jupiter. This is the Saturn. This is the Uranus. This is Neptune. This look. So not issue. Not an issue. Yes. So like this, we can teach any kind of abstract concept in a concrete manner to the student through. This is called markerless because I am not using any kind of specific paper to generate this kind of experiences. This for is called markerless. The next level, that is called the next level is called. So then the next level is called level 3, that is called augmented vision. So for viewing this, we need some kind of specific devices like Google Lens, not Google Lens means drone through the app. It's like a Google mirror. You can use the like the text, then only you can see this thing. So based on the wearable technology, it's an advanced level. Now the most of the people are using this. Now I think that I can stop this particular topic. I can move to the next topic. Before going to the next topic, just I like to conduct a small quiz. Are you ready? Are you ready to participate in the quiz? So I'm going to activate the phone.
Yes, thank you.
So I request all to come here to the chat. You can see the there's an activity button. Press the phone. I'm going to activate the questions one by one. Are you ready? So I can activate the people. I can activate the questions one by one. Yeah, the questions. Yeah, the first question. Just I'm going to launch it now. Can you give the answer? The immense technology that does EMA stands for. So this everything's called EMA technology, the excellent technology. What is EMA stand for? What is EMA stands for? You can give the answer and then check there. So you can
select. Microsoft.
So you given the answer? Yes. Then after that, you kind of vote. Then finally, you can see. So I got 29 responses. Very good. All are give the correct answer. Thank you so much. To give the answer and 5 of the wrong attempt, not an issue. So altogether, I got the 41 outputs. So from this, 38 people have given the correct response. So can I go with the next question? Are you ready to attend the next question? Are you ready? Yes. Yeah. Yes. Now I'm going to the next question. The game launched the augmented reality into the spotlight in recent year. This is a game. It is a game. What is the game? Whether it's a Super Mario, Pokemon, or a World of Warcraft and Fortnite. What is the game? So here I'm selecting characters from the menu, you can see from here. What is the answer? Yeah. So a lot of people are giving the responses in the Pokemon. The answer is Pokemon. The answer is Pokemon. Exactly. The answer is Pokemon. So the answer is Pokemon. So here there is a network issue for me. That's actually a problem, but not an issue. Yeah, I'm going to make it the last, the fourth question. Kindly give the response. Yes, the fourth question. The augmented reality and virtual reality are the same. Are the same? The question for you. Whether it's true or false? No, exactly. Answer is correct. You can see the response. Yes, I got 56 responses. Out of 56 responses, all are give the correct responses. Yes, false. This is great, great. So thank you so much to the answer. And I'm moving to the last question. So two more questions are there. In the AR, so in the AR, level one represent. In the augmented reality, we are talking about a lot of levels, no? Level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3. What is level 1? So those are not connected with this activity. You can type the short form in the chat box. Only short form. Don't type different terms. You can type, for example, if you know that hyperlink is the correct answer, you can type H. Marker based means you can type EMB. Marker less means you can type EML. Augmented vision means you can type EAB. Yes, the answer is second one. The level one is called marker based AR. Marker based AR. For this question, the marker based is AR. So really wonderful. I got the 36 responses, 39 responses correct answer. It's a great one. So the last question to all of you, can you give the answer for the last question? In the AR, level one represents, level two represents. I'm just coming to read the last question. Yeah, the last question. What is the level two? Give the answer in the chat box. Those are not able to give the answer through the polling. You can give the answer. It's fine. So nice. The answer is correct. What is that? That is called marker less AR. Exactly. The answer is marker less AR. So thank you so much to give the answer. I hope now you've got some kind of insights about what is exactly augmented reality and other things. So now it's 11:51. Just I'm going to summarize this topic with small things, because I have the slides are there, but due to the time fact, I'm not able to show all the things now. If you like, I can share my website. From this, you can view this one. 1 minute. Just I'm coming back to the exact advantage of this tool. So we can nurture the learning process, increase the student participation in classes, improve and increase the memory retention to the students. It promote the interactive lessons in the classroom. It increase the sensory training. Into development and visiting the past and present, the future is possible. And other augmented reality education's advantages also I listed here. Increase the content understanding, learning arrangements function, long-term memory retention is all possible, improve activity performance, and improve collaboration, increase people motivation. So therefore, this much of possibilities that while incorporating this kind of augmented reality.